No matter what job you have in life, your success will be determined 5% by your academic credentials, 15% by your professional experience, and 80% by your communication skills. Of all the skills available to us, communication is perhaps the most powering. Good morning, everyone. I welcome you all to this webinar, Being Job Ready. I also extend a very warm welcome to Professor Nisha Agarwal, Principal, PGGCG 42, Chandigarh. Professor Nisha Agarwal has a competent experience of handling college administration and financial duties. She has an excellent experience of about 35 years and has the ability to train teachers to do their best. With excellent interpersonal skills and communication, ma'am is an expert in preparing college curriculum and managing student relations. Professor Nisha Agarwal co-authored a number of books on subjects like financial markets and institutions, financial services, etc. She has published many research papers in reference journals and presented papers in various national and international conferences. Without taking much time, I request Madam Principal to formally welcome our guest speaker, Dr. Sumedha Singh, and all the participants. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Shakti. Good morning, everyone. On behalf of the Postgraduate Government College for Girls, Sector 42, Chandigarh, I welcome you all to this webinar on all about being job ready. I also welcome our guest speaker, Dr. Sumedha Singh, Chairperson, School of Communication Studies, Punjab, today's event. Dear participants, as we all know that the importance of soft skills is growing every year, even despite the rise in automation and artificial intelligence, people are still required to solve problems, innovate, manage conflict, interpret, and make decisions based on information. Modern workplace is more demanding and complex, competitive and collaborative, and diverse than ever. To thrive under today's pressure conditions, you need a balance of hard and soft skills. Rapidly changing work environment, being able to cope with change is paramount. And that is when the soft skills come to the fore. Being able to adapt and demonstrate agility are the hallmarks of successful organizations and a successful human being. Hope this session with the expert helps you imbibe the very essential aspect. I would request all the participants to be attentive throughout the session and utilize all the learnings from today's session in their lives. So without any further delay, let us begin today's session.
Thank you, ma'am. A very good morning to everyone. Our speaker today is going to elaborate on the topic being job ready. Whether you, our young listeners out there, are job seekers or job givers, both the situations require a certain set of skills, the importance of which cannot be emphasized enough. I'm referring to soft skills, which are basically a cluster of personality traits, habits, attitudes, and social graces, which will help one to stand out in a crowd. It has been well said that hard skills make you qualified for a job. Soft skills help you to write a resume and to help you to get an interview to get the job. A Harvard study points out that 85% of our success at the workplace is attributed to soft skills and only 15% to technical skills. Our erudite speaker of the day will throw more light on the subject. Today, we have amongst us Dr. Sumedha Singh, Chairperson, School of Communication Studies, Punjab University, Chandigarh. She has done her doctorate in spiritual communication, and she likes to refer to herself as Happiness Guru. She has an experience of over 14 years of working professionally with both All India Radio and Doordarshan as a child artist, youth compere, casual announcer, and program and anchor. She's a trained theater artist, who has also lent her voice as a voice-over artist with leading telecommunication companies and brands. Airtel, Vodafone, Spice, BSNL, Hero Cycles, to name a few. She has an experience in corporate filmmaking for leading national brands as well. Dr. Singh is a trained corporate trainer in voice and accent, soft skills, branding management, and personality development. She excels at training in meditation, spiritual leadership, and self-branding. Well, that was quite a long introduction, but I didn't want to leave out anything. Welcome, Dr. Sumedha. Over to you.
Thank you, ma'am, principal, and ma'am Sonia Sikand. I'm highly indebted, grateful for this opportunity and for the exhaustive introduction. I was assuming that you will pick up some points out of that and just speak quickly. But then thank you for mentioning almost all of it. I think without further ado, shall we begin? Because are the students there? Am I audible? Okay. So, ma'am, do we have, because I can see only four or five two people. Do we have students here?
Yes, ma'am, definitely we have, because we are live streaming through the YouTube only.
Oh, this is live streaming through YouTube. Okay. Lovely. Thank you. Is my screen also visible?
Yes, ma'am. Just have the slideshow. Okay.
Is it there?
Yeah, ma'am, we can see it.
All right. So, very good morning to all the students and teachers once again. This is all about soft skills. That is what I was told, that I will be taking this session in soft skills. So, a few points that I will be covering up today in my presentation are the definition of soft skills, why soft skills, what are the objectives of soft skills, then what are the important sets of soft skills, how do you learn them, advantages, disadvantages, and a bit of conclusion at the end. Now, let us look at the broader picture first. We have been talking about soft skills. So, is there anything that we call hard skills as well? I don't know. Many of us must be aware of it, and many of us may not be knowing. But yes, with the moment we say soft skills, a very quick and common sense question comes to mind. Then, do we have any hard skills or not? Or are there any hard skills or not? So, yes, there are hard skills as well. However, there is a little bit of difference between soft skills and hard skills. As the name suggests, the hard skills, like software and hardware, you know, you have software which helps you run your data, your information, the content on computer, laptop, phone, whatever it is. However, can we run that data? Can we pass on the information without the hardware? No, it's not possible. Also, it is something like verbal and non-verbal communication. So, we do have verbal communication, we do speak, and the non-verbal communication. So, the verbal communication cannot be effective without the non-verbal communication. Similarly, vice versa. So, this is soft skills and hard skills. Hard skills cannot be complete without the soft skills, and the soft skills have no value without the hard skills. Let's try to understand first what hard skills are. So, they show that you are great for a specific job. For example, so we are generally not born with hard skills, you know. We do not know how to write when we were born. We do not know how to calculate when we were born. We do not know any other thing that we can do with our hands or our other parts of body except eating, drinking, passing the excreta out, laughing, smiling, crying. You know, these are a few things that we are born with. But we do not have any hard skills when we are born. These hard skills can be taught. They can be learned, and they can also be measured at the same time. A few abilities like writing, reading, math, coding, budgeting, and mixing drinks, etc. These are the hard skills. Now we also have soft skills. So So what is the difference between hard skills and soft skills is, as I said, we are kind of born with some of the hard soft skills, you know. For example, a person can be patient by nature. You cannot teach someone to be patient largely. However, if one realizes oneself that I want to be patient, then maybe that person could acquire that skill of patience. But generally, we are born with that ability, that nature. Other examples are etiquette, interpersonal skills, communication. More important than communication is listening, and also leadership. We are born with these traits. Leaders are usually born. You cannot teach a person to lead. Yes, there are training modules wherein we can teach how to lead, but usually people, I mean, no matter how much you learn, that will only be acquired. If you're not a leader by nature, if you're not a leader naturally, it's difficult to lead effectively. But then I say, exceptions are always there. So that is a bit of a difference between the soft skills and hard skills. Okay, I'm going to keep the presentation or my interaction with you largely in English. I assume most of you are okay with it. I don't know if students can also interact with me or not, and I cannot see the chat window right now, but please let me know if there is a question in between, if there is something that you want me to specifically touch upon, or maybe we can take that up at the end of the presentation. Now, to define the soft skills, coming back to what we were talking about, they are the abilities that are not unique to any job. They are not unique to any job, which means there are two questions for you. Are you a great communicator according to yourself? Please think about it. You don't have to answer. Answer to yourself. Are you a great communicator? Now, the word great is very, very subjective. What do you really mean by great communicator? So one example that I have shared here with you is Amitabh Bachchan. I believe he's a great communicator. I believe he is great in his soft skills. I know a few of his staff members, people who've been working with him for 30 years or over 30 years of time, who say that as an employer, as a boss, as an actor, as a co-actor, he's amazing. So what makes him amazing? Or for that matter, from this younger generation, if I talk about, another name that I can quote here is Varun Dhawan. So he's an amazing actor. Not only that, he's a great communicator. When he has to interact with the public, we see when he comes on these few shows wherein he has to promote his films, you know. So the way these actors speak, yes, they do have some scripts, but to deliver a script takes your natural ability, you know. You give the same script to me and take the same script yourself. I can be damn sure the mode of delivery, in spite of being taught, yours and mine will be absolutely different. That is the truth about the soft skills. So they're not unique to any job. Soft skills is something that is inherent. Soft skills is something that is there inside me. But then the moment I identify, the moment I realize, okay, this is something that is missing in me. For example, I don't smile a lot. Oh, I don't smile a lot, which means, can I consciously start and try smiling more often? I'm sure this is not going to happen overnight. And do try to think about it. How many of us smile mostly? How many of us, when we wake up in the morning, the first thing, as we come across our family members, how many of us pass smiles to each family member? When we enter our house, or if we are inside the house and a family member enters the house from outside, how many of us take out that moment out of whatever we are doing and pass a smile to that family member? Usually we don't, because that is not a part of our culture. We are not taught to smile. We are not required to smile. Our mothers do not say that as many times as you look at me in the day, you need to smile at me. And our mothers do not smile at us every time they look at us. Mother is the first school for a child. So that is missing. But then the moment we realize smile is the biggest tool that we have, all or the bare minimum that we can do to make any circumstance, any event better, is just smile at the other person. So can we acquire that? Can we learn that? Can we start doing that consciously? We are born with smiles and we can consciously make an effort to smile more often. So that is what soft skills is. It is also a cluster of personal qualities, habits, attitudes, and social graces. As I said, it is all inherent. It's a part of my system. You know, I do not have to go anywhere. I know how to smile. I know how to frown. I know how to say hello. I know that I should be polite. All these basic manners and etiquettes were taught to us in school. But then be true to yourself. How many of us remember that? Our schools actually did a very good job out of us. It was us who did not probably take it seriously. So this is the time for a revision. I'm not going to talk about anything new. I'm just going to give you a recapitulation. So soft skills influence how we interact with others. Yes, it does. And as many times as I say it is inherent, I am talking about that communication which is happening inside me. There is a communication which is happening inside of me all the time, you know. All the time I'm thinking, observing, I'm getting insights. I am building up my thoughts based on the exposure that I have. What I am today, I was not 5 years ago. And what I was 5 years ago, I was not even 5 years ago. What I am today, I was not when I was born. So things, as my exposure changes, as my training of mind changes, my soft skills do grow. They do develop. They do change. Now, here is a myth about soft skills. Showing up and succeeding in all of my academic courses is all that I will need to go and get a job. That is what the most of us know, you know. In recent times, there was somebody who was talking to me, and her daughter is a graduate now, or I think was about to graduate. And she said, what do you suggest, Sumedha? I think she should go for MA in history. My simple question was, why? The moment I asked why, this lady was kind of shockingly surprised, and she was looking at me. She was not expecting that question from me. You know, she said, what do you mean, why? She has to do an MA, and she had history as one of her major subjects in graduation. So I thought, let her do an MA. I said, why? You know, I was stuck at that why. Inside of my mind, I'm that child who keeps asking why? So this lady had no answer, and she must have thought that I was mad. She must have thought that she made a mistake discussing it with me. How many of us actually think about why and why and why and why? The course that you're pursuing, why are you pursuing that course? What was the need of pursuing that course? Why couldn't you pursue that course based on need? For example, you might have been a great singer. Why did you not start singing professionally as soon as you could and kept on completing your education side by side? Mostly sports persons do this. Children who are good in sports right from the beginning, they are usually thrown into the sports field. They join the sports organizations and they complete their studies side by side. So the younger they are, the more achievements they have, the better they perform. You know, so this is a myth. Your courses are not going to land you into a job or even sustaining of the job. Nowadays, it's not that case. You know, nowadays, it's not the eligibility criteria that you only fulfill and you grab a job. No, you have an exhaustive interview nowadays. And this interview actually takes you through stages. You will have interview stage one, interview stage two, interview stage three. And these stages, at each stage, they are looking at your personality. They're looking at the person you are. They're looking at what you have got inside of yourself, apart from that skill, that hard skill that you have probably. So it's a myth, actually. Let's not go by that myth. A little clear view of soft skills is they are skills, they are abilities, and they are traits that pertain to personality, attitude, and behavior. What personality you have. What attitudes you have. Many a time I've heard youngsters saying, bada attitude dikha rahi hai. Bada attitude hai iske andar to. What is that attitude? What is that attitude that you're talking about? You know, that attitude shows in your behavior. That attitude shows when you're talking to somebody. So yes, that is soft skills. And of course, behavior, which is based on the attitude. The attitude I have, I'll behave accordingly. If I'm happy inside, I cannot be sad outside. If I'm polite inside, I cannot be polite outside. There is no switch here. You know, you can't switch. Okay, at home, I'm like this. At work, I will be like this. No. That's not the case. If you're not polite at home, you cannot be polite at work. If you are not in habit of saying thank yous and sorries at your home, you will never be able to say thank yous and sorries at work or outside anywhere. If you are ego-driven at home, you cannot be non-ego-driven anywhere else. You know, so we really need to think about the attitudes, the values that we are carrying, which are changeable. We can, mind is trainable, you know, you can really train your mind in anything and you can actually change your nature. I have recently taken a U-turn. In the past couple of years, I used to be, over a period of time, I grew as a very aggressive and proud person, you know. So few years ago, I was that. I was not liking myself. Things around me were all negative. Circumstances inside of my family were growing bad, worse and worst, you know. And things were reaching a verge where everything was about to break. And that is when suddenly, you know, I realized it's all in the mind and the mind is trainable. So could I take a U-turn? I took a U-turn actually. And I just changed everything inside of me. I revised everything, trained my mind and became what I am today. You know, so soft skills are inherent. They can still be grown and developed. Then soft skills are not formal or technical knowledge. As I said, they are hard skills. This is what industry wants from you. You are definitely, you are studying, you're doing whatever you are doing today is because you need a career. You need to work. You need to go out in the world. That's why we are studying or we're doing what we're doing today. So oral and written communication skills is what the industry want at number one. Critical thinking ability. What is critical thinking ability? Thinking critically means, am I able to, so thinking in if then else. Thinking in terms of solutions. You have a problem? Do you have a solution? Are you coming to me with a problem every time? Or you're coming to me with a problem and probable solutions? Although you might not be having a permanent solution, but could you suggest something to me? Can we work together on working out the solutions? Which takes me to the next skill that the industry wants, which is the problem-solving skills. Yes, nobody needs a problem creator. Nobody needs a person who always points finger at problems. Madam, ye to isme ye problem hai, ye to nahi ho sakta. Sir, aisa to kaise kar payenge? Sir, nahi kar payenge hum. Ye logon ko nahi chahiye. Logon ko kya chahiye? Ye problem hai, kya hum isko aise sort out kar sakte hain? Kya hum isko waise sort out kar sakte hain? Okay, these are number 1, 2, 3 solutions that I have. Do you have something that you could suggest? Hamare Hindi mein ek, I don't know, local kahawat hai ya real kahawat hai, but bolte hain, jo bole wohi kundi khole. So, jo bolega, jo problem laega, it is expected of that person only that at least you give one solution. This is the problem, give at least one solution. So, people want problem-solving attitude. Nobody wants a problem-oriented attitude. You know? Then resourcefulness. Bahut zaruri hai. How many resources do you have? You know? To have solutions, you have to have resources. Resources include everything, most importantly, people. You know, so it is very, very important to network. As women, as females, we are, and in this male-oriented society, we are stuck up in our own arenas. It is even more important, but even more difficult for us to network. What do men do? They network all the time. Think about it. I'm giving you a very bold statement. What do men do? They network all the time. All they have to do is network, network, network. Because they don't have to cook. Because they don't have to worry what is to be there in the breakfast, in the lunch, in the dinner. They don't have to worry, okay, where do I go and procure this? They go to the market, they meet one person. Along with that one person, if 10 persons are sitting, that one man will meet, shake hands with all of them 10. Because that man largely is not scared of any abuse, any bad eyes that could be watching him. Although I'm saying it in double quotes because the circumstances have largely changed. You know, so resourcefulness, please work on your networking, meet as many people as you can and keep in touch with as many people as you can. You know, keep in touch means do whatever you like to do. Try to tap on the opportunity. See what matches that person's caliber and attitude. How can we talk? How can we be in touch? But do be in touch with people. Have resources in hand so that you can have solutions in hand. Then you have the ability to work productively on the team. That is the last skill that they want, not the first. Okay? Because this ability can anyway, if you have the first four, you will be able to work on the fifth one. Now, why soft skills? Because we need workplace sustainability. Your diploma, your degree, your certificate course will be able to get you a job, especially if you are a performer, you know. Even if you don't have soft skills, you might still land a job, a good job. You will not be able to sustain it if the soft skills are not there. Because with the help of soft skills, we will be able to take proper decision. Handling of interpersonal relationships, you know, the relationship between you and me. I would not like to talk to you if you're an arrogant person. I would not like to work with you if you're not a polite person. I would not like to work with you if you are self-driven, if you talk only in I am this, I come from this background, these are my degrees, these are my skills. If you're high-headed, sorry, not required. I may not be high-headed, but I am a human being and I need equal respect. So do we have that respect for individual, you know? So I will share a personal example here with you. Why personal? Because professional starts from personal. Like we say, charity begins at home. Revolution begins with one. Similarly, professionalism starts with personal behavior. That's why I want to share this one example with you. I was blessed with a son a few years ago. And after he was born, I started calling, whenever I would refer to him in Hindi, for example, if I have to tell somebody in Hindi that he is sleeping, so I would say, sab ye so rahe hain. Wo keh rahe the ki unhe doodh peena hai. Unko main bahar ghumane le jaati hoon. A lot of people around me started questioning me. They would raise a brow, you know. क्या बोल रही, किसके बारे में बात कर रही है? And people would ask me, आप किसके बारे में बात कर रहे हो? तो मैं बताती हूँ, मेरे बेटे के बारे में. तो अगर मुझे बोलना होता है कि my son is waiting for me at home, so there was somebody I met here in the department, I was rushing home actually, and I said, excuse me, I'm in a hurry, मेरे बेटे इंतजार कर रहे हैं. तो जब मैंने कहा मेरे बेटे इंतजार कर रहे हैं, तो she asked me, अच्छा twins हुए थे आपके? मैंने कहा नहीं, I have one son. And then she was like, I said, फिर बात करेंगे, अभी मैं थोड़ी सी जल्दी में हूं. Are you getting what I'm trying to say here? देखिए, हम अपने बच्चों को क्योंकि बच्चा समझते हैं, इसलिए हमारा एटीट्यूड बच्चों की तरफ वैसा होता है जैसा होता है. I'm talking about respect for individual. हम उस नन्हे से बच्चे को, थोड़े से बड़े बच्चे को, थोड़े ज्यादा बड़े बच्चे को, 5 साल के बच्चे को, 10 साल के बच्चे को बच्चा ही समझते हैं. इंसान नहीं समझते, बराबर नहीं समझते. एंड दैट इज व्हाई वी टेक रिलेशनशिप्स फॉर ग्रांटेड इन इंडिया. व्हाई आई एम सेइंग इन इंडिया, बिकॉज दैट इज व्हाई वी आर लर्निंग सॉफ्ट स्किल्स हियर. 10 साल पहले कोई सॉफ्ट स्किल पढ़ाता नहीं था, कोई सॉफ्ट स्किल सीखता भी नहीं था. एज अ ट्रेनर आई स्टार्टेड ट्रेनिंग इन सॉफ्ट स्किल 15 साल पहले लगा लो, लगभग 13-14 साल पहले मैंने सॉफ्ट स्किल्स की ट्रेनिंग देनी शुरू की थी. और तब मैं ये सोचा करती थी यार, हिंदुस्तानी सभ्यता ही सॉफ्ट स्किल्स है, तो मुझे हिंदुस्तानियों को सॉफ्ट स्किल्स क्यों सिखाना पड़ रहा है? वो इसलिए सिखाना पड़ रहा है क्योंकि कहीं छूट गया है पीछे, न्यूक्लियर फैमिलीज हो गई हैं, बर्दाश्त करने की क्षमता खत्म होती जा रही है. वी डोंट वॉन्ट टू टॉलरेट. सास ने कुछ कह दिया, ऐसे ही ऐसे कह दिया. थोड़ा सा पढ़ लिख गई, बीए कर ली, तो माँ ने और बाप ने ज्यादा कुछ कह दिया, तो ऐसे कैसे कह दिया? मैं कमाती हूं, अपना कमाती हूं. पहला होता है जल्दी से कमाना शुरू करूं ताकि पापा मम्मी की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी खत्म हो. एटीट्यूड, एटीट्यूडनल चेंजेस. तो जब मुझसे लोगों ने पूछा कि आप सभ्य के लिए ऐसी बातें क्यों करती हैं कि जैसे वो छोटे बच्चे नहीं है, बड़े हैं. द आंसर लाइज इन योर स्टेटमेंट. जैसे वो छोटे बच्चे नहीं है, बड़े हैं, क्योंकि जब वो बड़े हो जाएंगे तब मैं उनके बारे में ऐसे ही बोलूंगी. आज जब मुझसे मेरे कलीग्स बात करते हैं तो बोलते हैं और सभ्य क्या कर रहा था। कल को जब सभ्य अपनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का ओनर होगा, किसी बड़ी कंपनी का सीईओ एमडी होगा, तो यही लोग पूछेंगे मुझसे, अच्छा और सभ्य कैसे हैं। तब कोई नहीं पूछेगा सभ्य कैसे, क्यों, क्या बदल गया, स्टेटस। इंसान को इंसान समझे अगर और ट्रेनिंग वहीं से शुरू कर दें तो याद रखने की जरूरत ही नहीं पड़ेगी किसी को क्या बोलना है। आई होप आई एम एबल टू मेक माई पॉइंट क्लियर हियर। रिस्पेक्ट फॉर इंडिविजुअल इज द बिगेस्ट सॉफ्ट स्किल इन कम्युनिकेशन ट्रेनिंग दैट वी मस्ट हैव। वी हैव टू रिस्पेक्ट द अदर पर्सन्स आइडेंटिटी, वी हैव टू रिस्पेक्ट द अदर पर्सन्स एग्जिस्टेंस, बी इट मेड, बी इट द स्वीपर, बी इट द जैनिटर, एनीबडी। I'm naming these professions because usually they are looked down upon. So can we consider everyone equal? Can we start doing that in our personal lives so that we don't have to train, we don't have to switch on and switch off in the professional life, you know? And that will automatically improve your interpersonal skills, interpersonal relations, which is point number two. You will be likable. You will be an adorable personality. Everybody will want to talk to you because you respect everybody. Respect is first, love is second. I don't want love. Please don't love me. Even if you respect me, I'm happy. That's what I tell my husband all the time. It's okay, don't love me. I don't need your love, but I do need your respect. And I will not allow anyone to disrespect me. Similarly, I will not allow myself to disrespect anyone. So yes, I am a human being. It happens, but then I apologize. I ensure that that was a disrespect that I did. That takes you to the third point, communicating with others properly and effectively, which will lead to gaining of professional development and having good impact and impression on others. So these are all intellect. Objectives of soft skills, usually inspiring leadership excellence and dynamic communication, managerial effectiveness, team building, time management, corporate grooming, all of these are keywords which I will be taking you to. Anyway, I'm going to share this PowerPoint with your college. The college can share it with you. So I'm not going to delve into the things which do not need any explanation. Public speaking, presentation skills, interpersonal and time management skills, motivational training, practical orientation. These are a few objectives of learning soft skills. Why we should learn soft skills so that we can end up with all these traits. These are personality traits. What are employers looking for to get hired? Please see this very, very carefully. The right mix of the right hard skills and soft skills in the right way. I have just talked about this. I'm not going to talk about this anymore. What are employers looking for? Again, these are a few skills, but the ones in blue are most important. So I'm going to touch upon those only. The employers are not looking for leadership, because leadership emerges when you work in a team. I have seen people who were zero, who were introverts, but who have proved to be great leaders. I have seen students in my department, I have seen colleagues who joined in, who were shy in the beginning, but who are managers today, you know, managing big teams. Because leadership can be acquired, it can be learned. Decision making cannot be acquired. Decision making is inherent, you know. Your logic is inherent. Your reasoning is inherent. So do work on that. You have to be a quick decision maker. I'll quote an example. In one of the army interviews, people were being interviewed to be inducted into army. So there was this one interview going on, and the committee asked this one person. So the person came into the room and the committee said, "Welcome, please come sit." So the person sat down. And that was the break time, actually. So the committee was actually having tea. So while they were having tea, out of courtesy, they also offered to that person. And they said, "What would you like to have, tea or coffee?" So that person said, "Nothing." So the committee said, "No, have something, whatever you want. What would you like to have, tea or coffee?" So this person said, anything, sir, anything. Again, no, please tell us, what would you like to have, tea or coffee? Okay, sir, maybe tea. The committee rang the bell. The attendant came inside the office. The committee requested the attendant to take that person outside with respect and serve him tea in the waiting gallery, and told that person, thank you for coming. The person did not realize, could not understand what happened. And so he had that question in his eyes. He asked, what happened, sir? Are you going to call me again for the interview? The committee said, no, your interview is over. The person had tears in his eyes and said, over? He did not even ask me any questions, sir. They said, we did. We did ask you, what do you want to have, tea or coffee? You could not decide for a few minutes. Jab saamne dushman khada hoga, to sochte rahoge ki goli maaru ki nahi maaru. Decision aise hota hai. Thank you so much. That person was crying till date. Aaj tak ro raha hai. You know? Ek aur interview senior school teachers ke liye tha. उसमें एक फीमेल आई, एक शहर से दूसरे शहर जाना था उनको. इंटरव्यू में पहुंची तो इंटरव्यूअर्स ने पूछा, आइए बैठिए, और सफर ठीक रहा आपका? हाँ जी ठीक रहा. अच्छा, दिक्कत तो नहीं आई कोई? नहीं जी, दिक्कत नहीं आई. अच्छा, तो मैडम ये बताइए कि आप जब अपने घर से यहां स्कूल तक आई हैं तो बीच में कितने मोड़ आए? कितने मोड़ आए बीच में? मैडम काउंट करने बैठ गई. अच्छा, पहले मैंने घर से लेफ्ट टर्न लिया, फिर राइट टर्न लिया, फिर अच्छा वो टर्न लिया. बोली, सर दो मिनट में सोच के बताती हूँ. हाँ हाँ, आप आराम से सोचिए, हमें कोई जल्दी नहीं है, बिल्कुल आराम से सोचिए. सोचती रही, वो कैलकुलेशन बीच में गड़बड़ हो रही थी ना भैया, एक शहर से दूसरे शहर गई है, एक कॉलोनी से दूसरे कॉलोनी भी जाना हो तो भी कितने मोड़ आए, कैसी कैलकुलेशन, कौन याद रखता है यार कितने मोड़ आए. मैडम को पसीने आ रहे थे, बुरी हालत थी. एंड में हार मान ली, सर मुझे बिल्कुल याद नहीं आ रहा कि कितने मोड़ आए, आई एम सो सॉरी सर, मुझे पता ही नहीं था कि आप मुझसे ऐसा क्वेश्चन पूछने वाले हो. सर मैं तो अपने सब्जेक्ट की चीजें याद करती भी आ रही थी, सर प्लीज मेरे सब्जेक्ट से रिलेटेड कुछ पूछ लो सर, ये सर वो. सर बोले, मैडम पढ़ाओगे तो बाद में, सब्जेक्ट तो बाद में आएगा, पहले तो एक इंसान होने के नाते दूसरे इंसान से डील करोगे. आप जब अपने घर से यहां आए तो दो मोड़ आए, एक लेफ्ट और एक राइट. आई डोंट नो व्हाट टू से, यू नो, ऐसा भी लगता है कि शायद उन्होंने इसको हायर ही नहीं करना था, जानबूझ के ऐसा क्वेश्चन पूछा. बट दूसरी तरह से देखा जाए तो हैंडल करने का तरीका अलग हो सकता था, उतना काउंट करके दिखाने की जरूरत नहीं थी, क्योंकि क्वेश्चन सुनते ही पता चल गया था कि ट्रिकी क्वेश्चन है. सॉफ्ट स्किल्स, ऑनेस्टी. डिसीजन मेकिंग हैपेंस विद ऑनेस्टी. यू डोंट नो इट, जस्ट एडमिट, यू नो. कम्युनिकेशन, देन देयर इज लिसनिंग. लिसनिंग इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स इन आवर लाइव्स वी आर ड्रिवन बाय प्रेजुडिस. We are driven by stereotypes. We respond before even the other person completes the question because we assume. So we have to stop doing that. We have to learn to be quiet, and we have to learn to hold on till the other person finishes. Listening is very, very important. Teamwork is there. Time management, again, most crucial, detail oriented. Every single thing. कोई आपको कागज देता है, मैम एक बार चेक कर लेना इसको पढ़ के, डिड यू गो थ्रू ईच एंड एवरी वर्ड बिफोर साइनिंग, यू नो. कोई आपको बोलता है कि एक इवेंट होने वाला है, जरा कमरा देख लेना. आपने बड़ा बढ़िया कमरा एकदम लगाया, कैमरा लगा दिया, टेबल लगा दी, जितनी कुर्सियां चाहिए थी उतनी लगा दी, बिल्कुल प्रोटोकॉल के हिसाब से आपने डेस्क सेटअप कर दिया, सब कुछ टिच, प्लांट्स लगाए सुंदर सुंदर, फूल भी लगाए सुंदर सुंदर, चाय का बढ़िया अरेंजमेंट कर दिया आपने, आपके चीफ गेस्ट आ गए, वो बैठे प्रिंसिपल मैडम के साथ, बैठे हैं डायस के ऊपर, है ना, और सोनिया मैम जो है वो अनाउंसमेंट कर रही हैं, तो चीफ गेस्ट वेट कर रहे हैं अपनी बारी की और देख रहे हैं हॉल में इधर उधर, और प्रिंसिपल को कह रहे हैं मैडम जाले नहीं उतरवाए आज आपने, जाले लगे हुए, और प्रिंसिपल घूर रही है शक्ति मैडम को, मैडम ये ठीक नहीं किया आपने, मिलिए आप मुझे बाद में, बात करते हैं इस बारे में, डिटेल, यू नो, सो डिटेल ओरिएंटेड, जोक्स अपार्ट, वी हैव टू रियली लुक इनटू ईच एंड एवरी डिटेल, कस्टमर सर्विस, कस्टमर्स डिलाइट, नाउ कस्टमर डजंट मीन रियली अ पर्सन हु इज पेइंग यू फॉर समथिंग, कस्टमर मीन्स एनीबॉडी हु इज द स्टेक होल्डर, एनीबॉडी हु इज गोइंग टू बी अफेक्टेड विद व्हाटएवर यू आर गोइंग टू डू, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग, वी जस्ट टॉक्ड अबाउट ऑल ऑफ दीस. Also, here is a small example of job description that I have shared with you for soft skills. Let us assume, accountant wanted, good written verbal communication, must be dependable and strong work ethic. ये तीन soft skills हैं. मुझसे अक्सर बच्चे पूछते हैं मैम resume में soft skills या strengths क्या लिखें? Look at the job description. The job description will give you everything. All you have to do is just pick up the right things from there. The job description says they want a person with good communication, dependable, strong work ethic. Likh to nikal ke copy maro chepo apne resume mein khatam. Hard skills kya chahiye? Jo maine light kiya hua hai green mein, written and verbal skills chahiye unko. Bookkeeping aani chahiye aapko, data entry skills aane chahiye, accounting functions aane chahiye. तो ये डाल दो अपनी हार्ड स्किल्स में, जो आप मांग रहे हो जी वो मेरे पास है. सो मोस्टली व्हेन यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग अ रिज्यूमे द जॉब डिस्क्रिप्शन विल टेल यू व्हाट टू पुट इन योर रिज्यूमे इफ यू लुक केयरफुली. अनदर एग्जांपल आई हैव पुट ओवर हियर फॉर अचीवमेंट्स. यूजुअली पीपल वंडर व्हाट शुड बी आवर अचीवमेंट्स दैट वी मेंशन इन द रिज्यूमे. जिंदगी में अचीवमेंट्स तो बहुत तरह की हैं, लेकिन रिज्यूमे में क्या डालें हम? तो ये एक प्रिटेंड जॉब एड है जिसमें लिखा हुआ है वी वांट अ ग्राफिक डिजाइनर स्किल्ड इन कम्युनिकेशन, टीम वर्क, ई कॉमर्स एंड ऑनलाइन लेआउट. चार चीजें मांगी है, सिर्फ यही चार चीजों में अपनी अचीवमेंट्स बताइए और अचीवमेंट्स मत बताइए, क्योंकि उन्हें चाहिए ही नहीं. उन्हें गुड स्पोर्ट्स पर्सन चाहिए ही नहीं, चाहे आप इंडिया प्लेयर हो, उन्हें चाहिए ही नहीं, तो आप क्यों बता रहे हो उनको? That is why every resume every time has to be customized, you know, with the skills that the employer is looking for. So here are again a few examples of soft skills and hard skills on a resume. Collaborated and this is how that will look, bullet points, you know, collaborated and communicated daily with a marketing team of 15 people. Important points and collaborated, communicated. Gave monthly progress presentations on the team. Important point hai, gave presentations. Facilitated team meetings for a project that increased revenue for e-commerce clients. 15%. I am talking data. Main hawa mein baat nahi kar rahi hoon. To maine ye kaam kiya jisse ki organization ko ye labh mila. Itne percent ka, itne rupaye ka, itne logo ka. You are talking in terms of numbers. You're talking in terms of measurable quantities. You're not generally saying I was a good communicator. Prove that you were a good communicator. What did you do? What project? What is your achievement that proves that you are a good communicator? That is how you decide your achievements to be put in your resume. Also, do not copy paste. At the time of copy pasting, at least look for synonyms. These are like I'm likable. You know, I'm highly skilled. Copy pasted cheezein nahi chahiye. So, isko prove karo how. How is more important? So this is one example. Wrote 1.5 million words of published articles in 2017. Exactly bataya ki maine kya kiya. I am highly skilled. This proves that I am highly skilled because this is the number of words that I wrote and I got published. Not only I wrote, I got a publication. That means a journal or a printing press or somebody recognized what I did and published it somewhere. You know, so that's how we prove it, whether it is a hard skill or a soft skill. We need to back it up. We need to think in terms of how I did it and how I can prove it. These are a few synonyms for communication skills, for common skills, actually, that we put in the resume. Hardworking, excuse me, generally people say in their resume, I'm hardworking. So you can say I'm dedicated, I'm diligent. Most prize of all, this is what is more important. Personable synonyms, affable, amiable, easygoing, likable, great, interpersonal soft skills. So these are a few terms that you can use. Time management ke liye aap use kar sakte hain, good at scheduling own work, fast, efficient. But ek baat phir se bol rahi hu, do remember, whatever you are putting as a quality, as a soft skill or a hard skill, you have to back it up with, you have to prove it with your achievements. Aise nahi likh dena ji, I am likable. Batao, kya kiya aisa ki tum likable ho? You know, if you say that I am efficient, so how do I know? How will you prove it that you are efficient? Did you do something that proves that you are efficient? Ye kuch aur hai, dependability synonyms hai, loyalty, trustworthiness, fast learner, creative, certified. Yes, I am certified in a few things. So I'm saying I'm certified and then I'm telling in my qualifications, these are the certifications that I have done. So keep proving whatever you are doing. Now, these are important sets of soft skills, communication skills, leadership, creativity, interpersonal skills, and professional skills. Quickly, let's look at them. Communication skills mein, verbal communication aati hai, presentation skills aate hain, listening, public speaking, humor, interviewing, and writing. Humor. Humor is one important skill. Internationally. Humor is one important skill internationally or globally, I must say. Everybody across the globe, and trust me, what I'm saying comes from experience. I have worked with multinational organizations. I have worked interculturally, internationally, and I have been an intercultural communication trainer. So I'm telling this with experience, from experience, that humor is one skill that is highly admired. You know, if you are humorous, if you have that thing in you, you can show it in your interview, you are definitely hired. Everybody wants a light-hearted person in their team. Everybody wants a person who can, you know, take things into that stride of humor. So even if you do not have it in you, humor, you can train, although it's a trait that you're born with, although, yet, you can still train yourself in humor. Little bit of training can be there. And as you go on in that training, in the practice, you will be able to do better in this. Listening, I've already talked about. Interviewing is very, very important. Now, here in interviewing, I would also like to mention small talk. I don't know how many of us are aware of small talk or not. But then small talk is something, for example, I'm standing in the, or you and I are waiting for the interview in a hall, you know, sitting. So we say hi. Acha time kya ho gaya? Phir aur kuch baat karni hai to acha laga milke ek dusre se na. To aur baat karni hai to yaar is baar garmi badi tezi se badh rahi hai na. Acha aapka experience kya hai? Phir usme kuch samajh mein aa gaya ki ye experience hai. Okay, so then talk about something else. So the moment you, that is, I'm giving you some tips for networking. Small talk helps you in networking, because small talk leads to getting to know each other, getting to know each other's interests and preferences, hobbies, likes and dislikes. So that will help you make friends professionally. And writing, of course, that requires a lot of working and practicing. So we can have a different session about how to write effectively. Then there is team building, strategic planning. These are leadership skills, you know, supervising, decision making, delegation, mentoring, giving feedback. All these are trainable. Mind can be trained in team building, how to build good teams. Mind can be trained in strategic planning. Mind can be trained in how to supervise, you know. Although these are the traits that right from the birth, inside the family, we were doing all these things. Team building amongst the cousins, team building amongst the relatives, strategic planning. You know, you have a birthday party at home. How do you go about planning it? So what strategies do you have so that effectively and efficiently you can have that party? So usually these things happen at home also, at personal level also. So leadership begins at that personal level. If you think you have it in you, great. If you think you don't have it in you, but you want to acquire, these are all acquirable skills, soft skills as well as hard skills. Then interpersonal skills, networking, as I talked about, interpersonal relationships, dealing with difficult people, very, very important. Sometimes in your teams, you may have to, in the college, sometimes your teacher might team you up, group you up with a person you don't like. What will be the first instant reaction of yours? You will go to the teacher, especially if you're in good books of the teacher. Ma'am, please, mera group change kar do, ma'am. Mujhe inke saath nahi rehna. अच्छा यूजुअली टीचर्स को भी अपने फेवरेट्स चाहिए ही होते हैं. वो मना करेंगे तो वो फेवरेट बच्चा जो है वो आपको लाइक नहीं करेगा. सो यूजुअली टीचर्स भी कर देती हैं. व्हाट आई डू इज आई ट्राई टू कन्विंस दैट पर्सन बाय टेलिंग दैट पर्सन व्हाट कैन हैपन एट वर्क. व्हेन यू आर इन अ जॉब यू कैन नॉट गो टू योर बॉस एंड से यार बॉस मेरा टीम चेंज कर दो. टीम्स कैन नॉट बी चेंज्ड. टीम्स आर डन बाय द एचआर और द ओनर्स ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. योर बॉस कांट चेंज योर टीम. You know, so 9 out of 10 times you will have to work in that team with that person. What will you do? It's better to develop those skills, you know, how to deal with difficult people, yet being good with that person. Conflict resolution. All these interpersonal skills or leadership skills require a few inherent traits like patience. We have to be really, really patient. So somebody asked me, what's your name? So I said, Sumedha. The other person did not understand and said, sorry, what? I said, Sumedha. What? What's your name? Sumedha. Are you kya bol rahe ho? Thoda uncha bolo na. What's your name? Sumedha. Pagal ho kya? Ya theek se bata do aapka naam kya hai? Sumedha. Actually, I will be tagged mad. यार वो पागल है. बता दो यार. एक ना माधुरी दीक्षित की फिल्म भी है जिसमें वो एक बंदे को वहां वो कैफेटेरिया के बाहर खाना खा रहे होते हैं. वो उस बंदे को जाके बोलते हैं आपको गुस्सा आ रहा है ना. बंदा कहते हैं नहीं मैम मुझे कोई गुस्सा नहीं आ रहा. नहीं 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 आपको गुस्सा आ रहा है ना पक्का पक्का. बंदा कहते हैं नहीं मुझे गुस्सा नहीं आ रहा मैम. नहीं आ रहा मुझे गुस्सा. अच्छा ठीक. देखो अभी आपको गुस्सा आ रहा है. तो वो करती जाती है. वो बंदा कहता है नहीं आ रहा नहीं आ रहा नहीं आ रहा नहीं आ रहा मैम नहीं आ रहा. बोल दिया ना नहीं आ रहा. वो उस हद तक पहुंचा देती है उस बंदे को. वो उसके पीछे भागता है कुछ लेके उसको मारने के लिए और वो मजे कर रही है. तो ये सिचुएशंस है हमारी लाइफ की. पेशेंस यू नो हाउ पेशेंट वी आर. एंड इफ इट इज आपको गुस्सा आ रहा है ना अगर वो ऐसे नहीं चल रही बात तो किसी और तरीके से चला सकते हैं क्या. अगर कोई बंदा आपको टफ सिचुएशन दे रहा है. इफ यू आर इन अ सर्कमस्टेंस इन अ सिचुएशन एंड इफ दिस थिंग इज नॉट वर्किंग कैन वी थिंक ऑफ समथिंग एल्स दैट माइट वर्क एंड समथिंग एल्स दैट माइट वर्क एंड समथिंग एल्स दैट माइट वर्क इंस्टेड ऑफ सेइंग हो गया मेरा तो मैं और नहीं कर सकती. बिकॉज दे से इन द प्रोफेशनल वर्ल्ड नेवर से नो. नेवर से नो. हार कभी माननी ही नहीं है. राइट जो हार मान गए तो नौका डूब जाएगी. सो पेशेंस एंड्योरेंस स्माइल मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट ऑफ ऑल. नेवर लूज योर स्माइल. दैट स्माइल शुड बी जेन्युइन. यू शुड बी जेन्युइनली स्माइलिंग यू नो. पर्सनल ब्रांडिंग डू एंश्योर व्हाट एवर यू डू इज विजिबल टू एवरीबॉडी. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इफ वी डू नॉट नो व्हाट यू आर हु यू आर it doesn't really matter even if you are or not. You know, if I love you and I do not say I love you, it doesn't really matter that I love you. Mostly 9 out of 10 times, you know. So whatever we are doing needs to be branded properly, needs to be shown to people properly. And office politics is most important. Why only office politics? There is politics inside of the families. There is politics inside of the relationship. There is politics mostly within friends also. So it is there. Politics is there. Usse nafrat kyun karni hai? Can we take it positively? Can we have something positive? Me, Sumedha Singh. Bahar mein gaye baaki sab log. Unhone jo karna hai kare. Politics karni hai kare. Can I be unaffected? Unaffected is most important. Yes, I can be. If I'm happy within, nothing adverse, nothing negative from outside can really affect me. You know, so that is all about office politics and interpersonal skills. Creativity, again, in all these areas, problem solving, innovation, design sense, artistic sense, critical thinking, troubleshooting, how creative we are. Again, creativity leads to troubleshooting. Creativity leads to problem solving. I have to be really creative inside my mind to have a solution to the problems. We usually get angry because we do not have a solution. We usually get angry, we usually get restless, we usually get irritated when our creativity is absent. You try this as an experiment. You try to have something creative in your mind, your negativity will go away. You try to create something, that irritatedness, that anger will go away. Usually people say when you are angry, count to 10. Because when you have nothing to do, at least counting from 1 to 10 will divert your mind. I say when you are angry, just sit straight and breathe. Deep breathing. And when you are breathing, I say watch your breath. Watch your breath. It is something creative that I'm doing. I'm creating a sense of consciousness about my own breath. While I'm thinking about my breath, I'm not thinking about anything else. Here I'll tell you one story. There was a king who fell ill, and none of the doctors in his kingdom could cure him. Rajvaid ne bhi try kar liya, padoos ke rajyon ke vaidyon ne bhi try kar liya, bade mashhoor vaidyon ne bhi try kar liya, sab ne try kar liya. Raja ji theek hi nahi ho rahe the, unki halat kharab se kharab, kharab se kharab, aur kharab hoti ja rahi thi. Everybody was worried in the kingdom what happened to the king, you know. So finally jab halat bahut kharab ho chuki thi to munadi karwa di, announcement karwa di ki jo koi bhi raja ko theek karega use muh manga inaam milega. तो लोग अपने अपने रेमेडीज लेके आने लगे, किसी से ठीक नहीं हुए राजा जी. एक मुसाफिर था जो वहां से गुजर रहा था और उसने ये मुनादी सुन ली. वो द्वारपाल को बोला कि मैं चला जाऊं. लड़का सा था, यंग सा, और ऐसे लोटे पिटे कपड़े, लोटे पिटे हालात, कोई बहुत अच्छे दिखने वाला इंसान नहीं था. तो मैं जाके ठीक करता हूँ राजा जी को. हंसने लग गया दरबान भी देख के उसको, है तू क्या ठीक करेगा राजा जी को, खुद को तो ठीक कर ले पहले. कहते तो देख लो तुम, राजा जी ने मुनादी तो करवाई है. तो दरबान को भी उसको भेजना पड़ा अंदर. वो राजा के कमरे में पहुंचा, राजा से बात की और बोला सब चले जाओ, सिर्फ मैं और राजा रहेंगे. और राजा को बोला, राजा जी क्या समस्या क्या है आपको? तो राजा ने बताया, मेरा तो सर बहुत दुखता है, मेरे तो मुंह में पता नहीं क्या हुआ रहता है, मेरी तो गर्दन, मेरी तो छाती, मेरा तो पेट, मेरी तो टांगे, मेरी तो बाजुएं, मेरे को तो कुछ आता ही नहीं है, मैं बिल्कुल परेशान हो गया हूँ, राज्य नहीं संभाल पा रहा हूँ, वगैरह वगैरह. सो दिस पर्सन सेज, समस्या तो बहुत गंभीर है राजा जी, क्या किया जाए? राजा ने पूछा. कहता है लेकिन आप बड़े लकी हैं, यू आर इन लक. मैं मुसाफिर हूं, पता नहीं कहाँ कहाँ ट्रैवल किया हूं, ओ एक फलानी जगह पे गया था, ओ इतनी दूर से आया हूं चल के. वहां एक पहुंचे हुए साधु बाबा थे जो 100 साल से समाधि में हैं. उन्होंने मुझे ये मैजिक पोशन दिया, बस इतना सा ही मेरे पास है राजा जी, लेकिन आपसे इंपॉर्टेंट तो, राजा से इंपॉर्टेंट कुछ नहीं है, ये मैं आपको दे सकता हूं, लेकिन मैं कीमत लूंगा आपने. राजा कहते हैं ले लिया तूने जो कीमत लेनी है, तू मुझे ठीक कर. नहीं राजा जी, वो कीमत तो ले लूंगा मैं आपके ठीक होने के बाद, लेकिन इस पोषण को लेने की एक शर्त है. क्या शर्त है भाई? ये आपने सुबह खाना खाना है, लेकिन खाना राजा जी आपको पूरा खाना पड़ेगा प्रॉपर. आप कह रहे हो आपको भूख नहीं लगती है. तो राजा कहते चलो ट्राई करेंगे. तो आपको खाना पूरा खाना है, और खाना खाने के बाद 2 चम्मच आपने ये दवाई के लेने हैं, मैजिक पोशन की. पर राजा जी एक शर्त है, जब आप ये मैजिक पोशन ले रहे होगे ना, उस समय आपने हाथी के बारे में नहीं सोचना. तो राजा कहते हाँ हाँ ठीक है ठीक है, फिर लंच में यही करना है, फिर डिनर में यही करना है, लेकिन जब आप दवाई लोगे तो आपने हाथी के बारे में नहीं सोचना. तो राजा कहता है ठीक है. लड़का कहता है मैं 1 हफ्ते बाद दोबारा आऊंगा, देखेंगे क्या प्रोग्रेस है. चला गया राजा, ने वो दवाई लेनी शुरू कर दी. खाना खाते थे सुबह, अब दवाई लेने के लिए प्रॉपर मील खाना है तो प्रॉपर मील खाते थे, फिर लंच करते थे, फिर डिनर करते थे, लेकिन जब दवाई लेने लगते थे तो याद आ जाता था कि हाथी के बारे में नहीं सोचना। अरे यार अभी तो मैंने सोच लिया हाथी के बारे में, क्या करूं? तो मिनिस्टर से डिस्कस किया, मिनिस्टर ने कहा अच्छा राजा जी कोई बात नहीं, आप रहने दो, गड़बड़ ना हो जाए कहीं, लंच के बाद ले लेना दवाई। लंच के किया, फिर दवाई लेने लगे, फिर आ गया यार हाथी के बारे में नहीं सोचना, फिर सोच लिया हाथी के बारे में। ऐसे करते करते एक हफ्ता बीत गया, लड़का वापस आया और वापस आके उसने राजा जी को देखा, एकदम हेल्दी वेल्दी एंड फाइन राजा। वो मैजिक पोशन की शीशी ऐसी की ऐसी रखी हुई थी, कह रहा बोला राजा दवाई नहीं ली। राजा कहता यार मैं क्या बताऊं तेरे को, तूने कहा था हाथी के बारे में नहीं सोचना, मैं ये जब भी लेता हूं तो मेरे मन में हाथी आ जाता है। लड़का कहता है अच्छा समस्या तो गंभीर है, चलिए कोई बात नहीं, आप बताइए वैसे आपकी सेहत कैसी है, सर का दर्द कैसा है? तो राजा कहता है सर का दर्द तो नहीं फील हो रहा, ये कैसा है वो कैसा है, तो कुछ भी फील नहीं हो रहा। लड़का कहता है यू परफेक्टली फाइन, जाइए अपना राज्य संभालिए, मेरा मैजिक पोशन मुझे वापस कर दीजिए। क्रिएटिविटी, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट क्रिएटिविटी, अ प्रॉब्लम दैट वॉज देयर, nobody could solve it, but somebody who had a creative solution could solve it like this. Aur hamari sabhyata, Indian tradition, the world tradition is full of such stories, inspiring stories. So creativity. Main koshish karungi aur 5 minute mein wind up karne ki. Personal skills hi ye jinke bare mein main mostly baat kar chuki hu, friendliness hai, work life balance hai. Work life balance ka matlab ye hai kaam ke samay personal nahi aur personal ke samay kaam nahi. It's a skill which we have to acquire. It's a soft skill, and soft skills jo hai wo sirf profession ke liye nahi hote hain, soft skills hamare ghar ke liye bhi hote hain. Aisa nahi hai, again there is no switch ki main profession pe jaungi to soft ho jaungi, ghar pe rahungi to jaisi hu waise rahungi. No, it's not possible, it's impossible. टाइम मैनेजमेंट अगर मैं पर्सनल लाइफ में नहीं कर सकती तो मैं प्रोफेशनल लाइफ में कभी भी नहीं कर सकती। सो यू हैव टू बिगिन इट नाउ टुडे, डोंट वेट फॉर द अपॉर्चुनिटी व्हेन यू विल बी हायर्ड, बिकॉज व्हेन दैट अपॉर्चुनिटी विल कम इट विल रिफ्लेक्ट इन योर पर्सनैलिटी। सॉफ्ट स्किल्स दिखाई देते हैं, सॉफ्ट स्किल्स की अपनी एक चमक होती है, एक आभा होती है, वो पर्सनैलिटी में से निकल के आती है। बहुत सारे लोग हैं जिनसे मिलके इतना अच्छा लगता है, दिल करता है यार इनसे गले भी मिल लो, इनसे बैठ के गप्पे भी मार लो, इनसे और ज्ञान ले लो, इनसे और बातें कर लो, दोस्ती कर लो। वो लोग अंदर से सॉफ्ट हैं, उनकी सॉफ्टनेस बाहर नजर आती है। याद करो कोई भी एक हार्ड बंदा जिससे मिलके तुम्हें दिल करता हो कि दोबारा इससे मिलने का दिल कर रहा है, मुझे कोई नहीं याद आता। सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस, टेकिंग क्रिटिसिज्म वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। मैं अक्सर लोगों से जब लोग तारीफ करते हैं, वाह वाह सुमेधा जी क्या सेशन था, मैं कहती हूँ यार प्लीज मुझे बताओ कि सेशन में क्या कमियां थी, बिकॉज आई रियली रियली वॉन्ट टू इम्प्रूव, पीपल डोंट टेल मी। मैं इतनी जेन्युइनली पूछती हूँ प्लीज मुझे मेरी कमियां बताओ, बट हार्डली आई डोंट हैव फ्रेंड्स, बिकॉज जो कमियां बताएगा वही तो दोस्त होगा मेरा, वो जो सब मुझे तारीफ कर रहे हैं सब दुश्मन है मेरे। सो बट आई लाइक टू बी क्रिटिसाइज, आई लव टू बी क्रिटिसाइज, बिकॉज व्हेन आई एम क्रिटिसाइज दैट इज द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू इम्प्रूव, that is the opportunity to grow and develop. So never take criticism negatively. जो लोग आपको आपके बारे में खराब बातें बोलते हैं ना, वो सब आपके दोस्त हैं। उसको सोचो, उनको थैंक्स बोलो, उनकी वजह से ग्रो कर पाओगे, right? And enthusiasm, most important. जियो तो हर पल ऐसे जियो जैसे कि आखिरी हो। इतना जोश हर पल में होना चाहिए कि यही है बस जिंदगी, अगले पल का तो कोई भरोसा नहीं है। कैसे सीखिए सॉफ्ट स्किल्स? यू कैन टेक अ कोर्स, यू कैन हैव मेंटर्स, आई कैन बी वन ऑफ द मेंटर्स फॉर यू, और वॉलंटियर, खुद ही अपने आप करो, मेहनत करो, पढ़ाई करो, देखो, ढूंढो, ऑब्जर्व करो, परसीव करो और सीखो। अ क्विक रीकैप फॉर यू, सॉफ्ट स्किल्स आर ट्रेट्स दैट मेक यू अ गुड वर्कर, हार्ड स्किल्स आर एबिलिटीज यू लर्न इन स्कूल और ऑन द जॉब। एम्प्लॉयर्स वॉन्ट अ मिक्स ऑफ द टू, एम्प्लॉयर्स को आपके सॉफ्ट स्किल्स भी चाहिए और आपके हार्ड स्किल्स भी चाहिए। सो डोंट जस्ट लिस्ट स्किल्स ऑन योर रेज्यूमे, प्रूव देम विद मेजरेबल अचीवमेंट्स इन योर रेज्यूमे। सो दिस इज द कंक्लूजन। वन ऑफ द मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट थिंग्स टू टीच इज सॉफ्ट स्किल्स, एंड मोस्ट कॉमन रीजन फॉर नॉट हायरिंग, नॉट प्रमोटिंग एंड फॉर परफॉर्मेंस इवेल्युएशन ऑफ एनी। सॉफ्ट स्किल्स नहीं होते हैं तो ग्रो करना मुश्किल होता है, सॉफ्ट स्किल्स नहीं होते हैं तो कोई ऑर्गेनाइजेशन आपको नहीं चाहती है, हायर अगर कर भी लिया तो रिटेन नहीं कर पाएगी। सो दीज आर अ फ्यू थिंग्स, पिक वन स्किल, वर्क ऑन इट एंड प्रैक्टिस 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 प्रैक्टिस, बिकॉज प्रैक्टिस इज व्हाट मेक्स वन परफेक्ट। आई थिंक आई एम डन इन टाइम, आई वुड लाइक टू हैव क्वेश्चंस प्लीज।
Thank you so much, ma'am. And I think, you know, the way you said that if you want to capitalize wealth, let it be the wealth of networking and smile and teamwork. I'm sure if the students have any questions, ma'am, they are open to, they can please send us through. At the moment, ma'am, they are just very engrossed and they are quite happy, and they feel that the session has really brought a lot of delight to them. I don't see any more questions coming. I would request Aman to please to take over from here.
Aman, unmute yourself, please.
अमन जी, मैं आपको नहीं सुन पा रही हूँ.
अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ प्लीज.
आई एम सो सॉरी. गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन. दिस इज फॉर द पार्टिसिपेंट्स, दोज हु वांट टू आस्क द क्वेश्चन और गिव देयर ऑब्जर्वेशंस, व्हाटएवर, द फ्लोर इज ओपन फॉर द डिस्कशन. दे कैन पोस्ट द क्वेश्चंस इन दिस यूट्यूब चैट बॉक्स एंड वी कैन रीड इट. We can ask ma'am. So please, students and all participants, post your questions if you want to ask something.
Everyone is like very session actually.
I think all of them are very happy and they are appreciating ma'am your talk. Many of them are writing that this was an interactive session, this was very informative, and they are happy that they never, you know, had this idea about the soft skill before. So I think these are the observations they are giving now, and we are hoping that if any one of you have the question, you can post please.
I can read the comments here by attendees, the participants. Some of them are popping up on my screen, and I'm really, really thankful for your love and for the patient listening that the students and the participants have had. I would love to have any questions if you have, or even objections, any observations that you want to share. I would like to hear you. But thank you for all the compliments that you are giving me, and I'm really indebted.
Okay, so somebody has written that, ma'am, can you please again explain that the difference between soft skill and hard skill? So if you can, like.
Yeah. So soft skill is Najish Khanam, I think. Najish Khanam has asked this question. Najish ji, soft skill wo hai jise leke main paida hui hu. Mujhe muskurana paida hone se hi aata hai. मुझे रोना पैदा होने से ही आता है, मुझे गुस्सा करना पैदा होने से ही आता है. जो अपने से बच्चे होते हैं ना, फ्यू मंथ्स ओल्ड, वो भी रो के कुछ तो भी करके वो गुस्सा कर सकता है, लेकिन उसे लिखना नहीं आता है, उसे कैलकुलेट करना नहीं आता है, उसे किसी प्रॉब्लम का सोल्यूशन सोचना नहीं आता, राइट? तो जो स्किल्स लेके मैं पैदा हुई हूँ वो मेरे सॉफ्ट स्किल्स हैं, वो कुदरत ने मुझे दिए हैं. दे आर नेचुरल, यू नो, नेचुरली आई कैन बी हैप्पी, आई कैन बी सैड, आई कैन बी एंग्री. माय इमोशंस मोस्टली, दोज आर माय सॉफ्ट स्किल्स. हार्ड स्किल्स आर द स्किल्स व्हिच आई हैव टू लर्न टू बी एबल टू सस्टेन माय सेल्फ इन द सोसाइटी, और आई मे नॉट लर्न. देयर इज नो नीड टू हैव हार्ड स्किल्स, बट इफ आई वांट टू, if I want to be employed, I'm using double quotes for this, if I want to be employed somewhere, then I have to have the hard skills. If I want to have my own work, for example, I'm a painter. Painting is a hard skill. It could come naturally to me. I could have acquired that information from somewhere, but still I need some hard. I need to pick up a paintbrush, I need to draw on canvas. So that is a hard skill that I have. So that is the difference between soft skills and hard skills. Smiling is a soft skill. You know, thinking about the solution of a problem, thinking is a soft skill. So that is the basic difference. I think Pallu is able to answer your question.
There is another question. Somebody, Rajkumari Melody, she wants to ask that how can we develop the sense of humor, ma'am?
Rajkumari ji, aapne to na dil pe chot kar di ye question poochke, because I'm still struggling with acquiring the ability of humor. Mujhe khud nahi aata. I am a very serious person in life. So I'm learning myself, but मैं क्या कर रही हूँ वो आपको बता सकती हूँ. मैं कोशिश करती हूँ किसी भी सिचुएशन में, जैसे कि फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैंने ना नया कार वॉश का बंदा लगाया था जो कार वॉशिंग करने आता है, तो उसने क्या किया, वो पाइप लेके खड़ा हो गया पानी की और एक कपड़ा लेके खड़ा हो गया, तो वो पानी डाल रहा था एक हाथ से और एक हाथ से वो कपड़े से कार को साफ कर रहा था. तो थोड़ी देर के बाद मेरी नजर जब पड़ी, जब वो कार साफ करने खत्म कर चुका था, तो मैंने कार को देखा और मैंने उसको बुलाया. मैंने कहा यार इधर आ. हाँ जी मैडम. मैंने कहा यार तूने कार बहुत बढ़िया गंदी की है. एक पल को तो उसने सोचा, दूसरे पल को हंसने लगा, है ना. मुझे उसको गुस्सा भी करना था लेकिन गुस्सा नहीं भी करना था, तो मुझे लगा ह्यूमर इज द बेस्ट वे. सबसे बढ़िया तरीका ह्यूमर. बात को मजाक में आपने कह भी दिया और आपने नहीं भी कहा. इसको कई लोग सार्कैज़म भी कहते हैं. अब ह्यूमर और सार्कैज़म में ना थिन लाइन डिफरेंस है. मेरे हिसाब से सार्कैज़म वो है, सार्कैज़म वो ह्यूमर है जो सामने वाले के दिल को चोट पहुंचाता है. जब तक वो किसी का दिल ना दुखाए तब तक वो ह्यूमर है. तो जब मैंने ऐसा कहा तो उसने भी गाड़ी को देखा. मैंने कहा कर दे यार तुम्हारा साफ कर दे, ढंग से कर दे यार, साफ कर दे. You know, so that is one example. Try to find the light note in every situation. Baki, it will really come with practice. Whenever you have said something to somebody, go back and give yourself a feedback. मैं उस सिचुएशन में इससे बिल्कुल क्या कह सकती थी. आपको बार बार सोचना पड़ेगा, खुद को खूब सारा फीडबैक देना पड़ेगा, तब ये शुरू होगा. मेरा तो अभी तक नहीं हुआ है, ट्रस्ट मी. I'm so struggling.
In the brain, somebody wants to ask that, can suggest something that how can we develop patience within us?
Yeah, breathe. Remember to breathe. हम लोग सांस लेना भूल जाते हैं. सांस दो तरीके से ली जाती है. एक बायोलॉजिकल है, चल रही है क्योंकि हम जिंदा हैं इसलिए हम सांस ले रहे हैं. बट सोचो कि आपकी सांस पूरी अंदर जाती है बॉडी के. अक्सर देखोगे आपकी सांस यहां से वापस चली जाती है, यहां तक आती है, छाती तक आती है और छाती से वापस चली जाती है. हम में से कितने हैं जिनकी हर सांस लंग्स तक पहुंचती है. सो टू हैव पेशेंस, प्रैक्टिस ब्रीदिंग. हर सुबह उठ करके, हर शाम के 5 मिनट आंखें बंद करके बैठो और बहुत स्लोली डीप ब्रीद करो. फील करो कि ब्रेथ आपके बॉडी के हर सेल में जा रही है. हवा को, उस प्राण वायु को अपने बॉडी के हर एरिया में जाते हुए फील करो. प्रैक्टिस गुस्सा आए तो पॉज लो, सांस लो. एंग्शियस हो गए, पॉज लो, सांस लो. खुश हो गए, पॉज लो. हम खुशी में भी सांस लेना भूल जाते हैं. तो कोई भी एक्सट्रीम इमोशन है, बुद्ध बनने का एक ही तरीका है. हम सबको बुद्ध बनना है, बुद्ध तो बनना ही है. अगर सिद्धार्थ गौतम बुद्ध बन सकते हुए एक इंसान होते हुए, तो मैं भी बन सकती हूँ, आप भी बन सकते हो. ऑल वी हैव टू डू इज फोकस ऑन योर ब्रेथ. आई होप आई आंसर्ड योर क्वेश्चन इन द फ्री.
There is another question. Anu Sharma wants to ask that as India's employment rate is so low, it's reducing day by day, and the competition is increasing. I just want to ask that how to get motivated to keep going and face the rejection in job interviews.
The first thing that I want in my life is rejection, failure. That is how I was trained by my parents. मेरे पेरेंट्स ने सबसे पहले मुझे फेल होना सिखाया था. एंड आई एम सो थैंकफुल टू देम, बिकॉज फेलियर इज व्हाट मेक्स मी व्हाट आई एम टुडे. मैं जब तक फेल नहीं होंगी तब तक इंसान नहीं बनूंगी. जब तक मैं दुख नहीं देखूंगी तब तक मुझे सुख की वैल्यू समझ में नहीं आएगी। इसका एक बहुत छोटा सा और बिल्कुल सुपर पर्सनल एग्जाम्पल देखिए मैं आपको बताती हूँ। वैसे ये बात कहने की नहीं है, आई कम फ्रॉम एन अपर क्लास फैमिली एंड आई गॉट मैरिड इन टू अ मिडिल क्लास फैमिली। तो जब मेरे लिए शादी के रिश्ते आ रहे थे बिकॉज आई कम फ्रॉम अ वेरी इंफ्लुएंशियल फैमिली तो एक से एक रिश्ते आते थे। तो जो पहला रिश्ता आया तो मैंने बोला यार मैं ना जैसे बैठी हूं ना ये जो कपड़े पहने ऐसे ले जाओ मुझे, ना तो ढोल बाजे बजेंगे ना बारात आएगी ना मेरे घर से कुछ आपके घर आएगा, मैं जो हूं जैसी हूं वैसे ही जाऊंगी। तो ना हो जाती थी, नहीं नहीं सॉरी यार, और मेरे घर से लेन देन भी नहीं होगा, जो होते ना सास के इतने चाची के इतने ताई के इतने फलाने की अंगूठी कुछ नहीं आएगा मेरे घर से। तो फाइनली द मैन आई मैरिड एक्चुअली अग्रीड टू दिस, ही अग्रीड टू दिस कंडीशन एंड आई गॉट मैरिड व्हेन आई हैड नथिंग। आफ्टर मैरिज आई वॉज इन गुड़गांव, आई वॉज वर्किंग देयर इन द प्राइवेट सेक्टर एंड माई मामा फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम विजिटेड मी विद माई बुआ। आई हैड अ 3-bedroom हाउस बट जस्ट वन सिंगल मैट्रेस, वन सिंगल मैट्रेस ऑन विच माई हस्बैंड एंड आई यूज टू स्लीप। एक मैट्रेस था उस पर सोते थे और एक सिंगल सिलेंडर आता है छोटा सा, उसके ऊपर चूल्हा बना होता है, वो सिलेंडर था उस पर हम खाना बनाते थे। एक कढ़ाई थी, एक ग्लास था, एक प्लेट थी, एक चम्मच था। तो माई मदर वॉज क्राइंग, वो वहां बैठ के ना अपना सर पकड़ के रोने लग गए और वो बहुत रोए। वो कहते मैं कैसे जाके सो जाऊं एसी में, मेरी बेटी के पास तो टेबल फैन है, मैं कैसे जाके आम खा लूं, मेरी बेटी यहां पे जो भी जैसा भी है, क्या पागल हो गई है मेधा, तेरा दिमाग खराब हो गया, तू ये क्या कर रही है, क्यों कर रही है बेटे, तेरे पापा तुझे सब कुछ दे सकते हैं। मैंने कहा इसीलिए कर रही हूं, मुझे पापा का दिया हुआ नहीं चाहिए माँ, उसकी वैल्यू नहीं कर पाऊंगी मैं, जब अपने हाथ से कमाऊंगी ना तो उसे संभालना भी आएगा। आज ईश्वर की कृपा से मेरे घर में वो सब कुछ है जो मेरे पापा मुझे देना चाहते थे, लेकिन वो मैंने अपने हाथ से बनाया। सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स यू नो यू ग्रो, अपॉर्चुनिटीज नहीं है जीवन में, लेकिन कैसे मैं अपनी खुद की अपॉर्चुनिटी, मुझे अपने हाथों पे भरोसा है, मुझे अपने ऊपर भरोसा है, मुझे फेल तो करो मैं तुम्हें पास होकर दिखाऊंगी, है ना। फेलियर इज वॉट टीचेज अस, फेलियर इज वॉट टेक्स यू टू द न्यू लेवल, यू जस्ट हैव टू रिस्पेक्ट दैट। सी रिस्पेक्ट, रिस्पेक्ट एवरी सिंगल मोमेंट इन योर लाइफ एंड लव इट, एम्ब्रेस इट, जस्ट रिमेंबर ऑल इज वेल।
राइट मैम, I think before that Priyanki was also asking about the negativity which comes when after the rejection, and I think you already answered the answer Priyanki's question, ma'am. And okay, these are the questions, and I guess ma'am, Shakti ma'am, should we wait for some questions or should we move forward? Mike.
I think we can wind up now. Sumedha ma'am has already taken more, and we cannot give her any more chances to. I think we can just stop here and shield her from any more questions coming her way, because the students seem to have endless questions now after hearing it from her.
Yeah.
Probably we can have another session with her so that the students can again have a more interactive session with her, where you know they can probably have a physical. Meet when we can whenever we reopen in the college.
Okay, ma'am. So for the participants, I just want to mention that we have posted a link for Google form. Please fill the form for the e-certificates. Now to wind up this formal vote of thanks, ma'am, which is I think is the important part of any occasion. So on behalf of the English department and the entire fraternity of PGDCG 42 Chandigarh, I, Amandeep Kaur, take the privilege to propose a formal vote of thanks to acknowledge the contribution of those who worked hard to make this event a success. So first of all, ma'am, I extend my heartfelt gratitude to our esteemed and versatile speaker of the day, Dr. Sumedha Singh, Chair, Department of Mass Communication, Punjab University, Chandigarh. Thank you, ma'am, for accepting our invitation, sharing your valuable time with us and enlightening us, okay, and sharing your knowledge, of course, with us. Ma'am, you have beautifully defined the concept of soft skills, the importance of soft skills, and how these soft skills are important for each and every human being, no matter which field we work in. Okay, so I think for the students and the coming generations, and not only the coming generations, for us also who are already into the jobs or in the professional life, we need to update ourselves with the soft skills. We need to, you know, keep learning about the things and how to, you know, work on the workplace. So I'm sure, ma'am, all the participants and especially our students are motivated now and quite enthusiastic to develop those soft skills so that, you know, they can be ready for the jobs in the market, ma'am. So thank you so much, ma'am, for your wonderful presentation, ma'am. I also want to extend my sincere thanks to our worthy principal, ma'am, Isha Agarwal, for sparing time out of her busy schedule and gracing the occasion. On behalf of the organizing team, I thank you, ma'am, for your constant motivation, guidance, and support, without which this webinar would not have been possible. Thank you so much, ma'am. I also want to convey my thanks and regards to our HOD, ma'am, so Ms. Sonia Sikand, for her guidance, and Preeti, ma'am, librarian of the college, for her technical guidance throughout. Thank you so much, ma'am. And without you both, I think this it would have been difficult to manage this event. Okay, so thank you so much. Last but not the least, I really appreciate the enthusiastic participation of the students. Thank you all for being patient listeners, for putting your observations and asking the questions. And this habit of, or this practice of asking questions will, you know, definitely help you to develop soft skills within you. So thank you all the participants. In the end, I would like to congratulate all the members of the organizing team, Ms. Sonia Sikand, HOD, Department of English, Shakti Pathak, Assistant Professor, Department of English, Preeti Sharda, Librarian, PGCG 42 Library, and I, Assistant Professor in Department of English. And we are also looking forward to organize more such events in future, which can be helpful for our students to recognize and enhance their capabilities to be, you know, ready for jobs and ready for the market and to face whatever is coming in their way, you know, when they will be into the jobs. So I congratulate all the team members. I congratulate the whole PGCG 42 fraternity, our college family, for the success of this event. And thank you, Smita ma'am, once again, for sparing time for us, ma'am. Thank you so much. Over to you, Preeti ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am. In fact, I enjoyed the session very much and learned many things, especially the patience which I don't have. Thank you so much, ma'am. And we are signing off now.
Thank you so much.